स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू वेल एक्सप्लेन्ड। स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द रेयरिंग एंड ब्रीडिंग ऑफ शीप। दिस इज माय लेक्चर नंबर टू फ्रॉम द चैप्टर थ्री फाइबर टू फैब्रिक ऑफ क्लास सेवेंथ साइंस। द प्रोसेस ऑफ डोमेस्टिकेशन एंड रेजिंग ऑफ शीप फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ वूल इज कॉल्ड एज रेयरिंग। मीन्स किस तरीके से हम शीप को अपने पास रखते हैं, किस तरीके से उसको देखभाल करते हैं, क्यों देखभाल करते हैं, क्योंकि शीप हमें क्या देती हैं, वूल। तो ये जो पूरा प्रोसेस है किस तरीके से हम उसको रखते हैं और उसकी पाल पोस के बड़ा करते हैं और उसमें से हम वूल लेते हैं, दिस होल प्रोसेस इज नोन एज रेयरिंग। नाउ In India, sheep are reared mostly in northern states such as Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim. Students, you just have a look on all the states where the sheep is reared. They all are mountainous or hilly regions. Why sheep is reared there? Because sheep gives us wool. That means their body is covered with wool. And wool is warm. So if the sheep is reared in deserts, so it will die because of heat. Therefore, it is found mainly in the mountainous or hilly regions. Now coming to the feeding habits of sheep. Feeding habit means वो क्या-क्या खाते हैं. Sheep are herbivores. Herbivores means they eat plants and its products. Their main food is grass and weeds. What are weeds? They are the unwanted plants. Their feeds may also include jowar, oil cakes and a mixture of pulses and minerals. Oil cakes means the seeds, when the oil is extracted from those seeds, whatever is left over is known as oil cakes. Now, the home of the sheep, that means shelter place. For their shelters, sheds with gunny bags and thatched roofs are preferred. Their shelters should be kept dry and well ventilated. Well ventilated means lot of air should be air and sun should be sunlight should enter their shells. That means they must have doors and windows. Now, what is selective breeding? The process of selecting parents. Selective means something is selected. Why we select some things? For their good qualities, and then breed them means they are made them so that the offspring produced will have the desirable characteristics of both the parents, means good qualities. The process of selecting parents for obtaining desirable characteristics in their offspring is known as selective breeding. सपोज एक शीप है जिसकी वूल क्वालिटी बहुत अच्छी है एंड देयर इज वन अनदर शीप विच इज डिजीज रेजिस्टेंट, मीन्स उसे बीमारियां नहीं होती हैं। एंड व्हेन दीज टू शीप अ मेल एंड अ फीमेल दे आर क्रॉस्ड और मेट दैट प्रोड्यूसेस द ऑफस्प्रिंग, मीन्स जो उनके बच्चे पैदा होंगे दे विल बी हैविंग द क्वालिटीज ऑफ बोथ। दैट मीन्स दैट ऑफस्प्रिंग विल बी हैविंग अ गुड क्वालिटी वूल एंड इट ऑल्सो विल बी disease resistance. Now why this selective breeding is done? This is done, number one, to improve the production and quality of wool. That means good quality wool is produced. Second, to produce disease resistant varieties. Disease resistant means unko bimariyan nahi hoti hain ya jaldi jaldi nahi hoti hain, means they are healthy ones which can resist the occurrence of diseases. Third is to improve the appearance of wool fiber and wool type. Means जो wool का fiber है it should be lustrous, elastic. That qualities of the wool fiber and type to improve them. And number four, to develop varieties that have better tolerance to extreme environmental conditions. Extreme environmental conditions, if it is too hot, so they can survive that. Or it is too cold, then also they may survive. Now processing of fleece to fabric, that is wool production. The process of wool in fabric from the sheared fleece involves the following steps. Now the sheep are reared, they are domesticated, means unko humne paal pos ke bada kar liya, they are having wool. Now how come we'll get this fleece and convert it to the fabric, that is wool? The very first step is shearing. The process of removing fleece from the body of animals like sheep is known as shearing. That means how to remove the fleece. This shearing or the removal of the fleece is done with the help of clippers or a pair of scissors and shearing machines. As there are shaving machines, you have seen the gents or the papas or the big brothers, they shave, they remove the hills. In the same way, shearing machines are there, and with the help of that, this fleece is removed from the body of animals. This shearing is mainly done in summer months. Why? Because if in summer months this coating is removed, then it will help to keep the body of the sheep cooler. Means they do not feel hot, because in summer months the temperature is high. Now second step. Now once the fleece is removed, now second step is the scouring. As the fleece removed consists of grease and dirt. अब जो फ्लीस आया उसमें डर्ट भी है, ग्रीस पार्टिकल्स मीन्स ऑयली स्टिकी थिंग्स हैं, देन इट इज वॉश्ड विद डिटर्जेंट एल्कलीज एंड वाटर इन लार्ज टैंक्स, मीन्स उसको फिर धोया जाता है. आफ्टर रिमूविंग द फ्लीस इट इज वॉश्ड विद डिटर्जेंट मीन्स वॉशिंग पाउडर. दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ वॉशिंग द फ्लीस इज नोन एज स्काउरिंग. Now the third step is sorting. Sorting means classifying, means dividing into different groups, but sorting also means to remove any damaged and stained wool from the fleece. Means agar jo fleece hai koi kata phata sa usme part hai wool ka ya koi stain means daag laga hua hai to usko wo alag kar dete hain. Got it? Now the fourth step. There are 8 steps. The fourth step is known as grading. Grading means after sorting means the removal of the stained or the damaged wool. This wool is sorted. Sorted means kept in different groups according to their length, color, texture, and ease of dyeing. Means these are the 4 things which tells in which category the wool will be kept. What are they? The length, color, texture, and ease of dyeing. And this whole process is known as grading. Now the wool is graded, means kept in different groups. The next steps comes the dyeing. Dyeing means to color, coloring of the wool. We have studied in the characteristics of wool that the natural color of the fleece is white, brown, or black. So the sheared wool, now it is dyed into various colors depending on requirements, because we have seen that wool comes in almost every color, but that is not naturally, that is dyed, means colored. After dyeing, next step, that the sixth step, is drying. This wool is dried. And dyed wool, how it is dried? It is made to pass through machines which squeezes extra water. Means usme se jo extra water hai wo nichod lete hain, squeeze kar lete hain. After drying, it is then packed into bales for transport to mill. The seventh step is spinning. The fibers after drying are oiled, they are straightened, they are combed, washed, twisted, and then they spun into yarns. Means fiber se pehle kya bana? Yarns. And from yarns, what is formed? Fabric. The fibers are straightened by keeping them under rollers to stretch them and twisted into yarns. Now the last step is, when the yarns are formed, then Next step is weaving and knitting, means how the fabric is made. The larger fibers, they are spun into yarns and knitted for making sweaters, whereas the shorter fibers are, they are spun and woven into other woolen clothes. You can see from the diagram, all the steps are there. Shearing, you can see that the sheep is, that fleece is removed. Then scouring, scouring means it is washed. Then sorting means any damaged or stained wool that is removed. Then grading means the wool is divided into different groups according to their length, texture, ease of dyeing, etc. The next step is dyeing. After dyeing, there is drying. Drying, then weaving or knitting, and the fabric is formed. So that is how the wool is produced. Now, all this processing, that is rearing, domestication, how this wool is produced, this whole process is, it comes under wool industry. Now, there are certain health hazards. Health hazards means there are certain diseases which can occur to the persons who are working in this wool industry. The major health hazards faced by the people working in wool industry are the sorter's disease. Sorter means sorting ek stage thi humne dekha tha wool production mein. In that, this wool, the damaged and the stained wool is taken out. So people working in wool industry, they suffers from this disease known as sorter's disease, and this disease is caused by a bacteria called as anthrax. Learn this, which bacteria causes sorter's disease? Anthrax. Now in this sorter's disease, there is skin, lungs and intestinal disorders, and it also results in the lesions in arms, neck and lungs. Lesions means zakham ho jate, means ghao ban jate hain. Ahi baat samajh mein? Skin, lung and intestinal disorders hote hain, plus ghao ban jate hain arms, neck and lungs mein. Number 2, the people working here also suffers with hearing loss due to the loud noise made by the machines during the processing of wool. Means, jab wool processing ho rahi hai, to machines chalti hai wahan pe, aur machines itna shor machati hai ki log wahan par kaam karte hain, unko hearing loss ho jata hai. Means, unki sunne ki shakti jo hoti hai, wo kam hoti chali jati hai. Got it? Now, number 3, the usage of chemical dyes. डाइंग करते वक्त हमने जो कलर्स यूज कर रहे थे, एक्चुअली वो क्या होते हैं? केमिकल्स होते हैं. एंड द यूज ऑफ दीज केमिकल डाइज मे रिजल्ट इन द इरिटेशन ऑफ आईज, आंखों में जलन वगैरह, इन्फेक्शन ऑफ स्किन, लंग्स एंड समटाइम्स ब्रीदिंग प्रॉब्लम्स में आल्सो अकर. एंड द फोर्थ इज इनएप्रोप्रिएट वेंटिलेशन, हाई टेम्परेचर्स एंड ह्यूमिडिटी एट द वर्क प्लेस also affects the general health of workers. Means agar ventilation proper nahi hai to koi bhi problem ho sakti hai. High temperatures rehte hain ya bahut zyada moisture hai, humidity hai, workplace means jahan par wo log kaam kar rahe hain, so it also affects the health of the workers. So that's all for the wool. Okay, now in the first lecture and the second lecture we have finished the first animal fiber, that is wool, and my lecture 3 and 4 you will come to know about the next animal fiber, which is silk. So thank you, thanks for watching.